Hey, this is Seth with In Demand Career. I show people how to get jobs in digital marketing with no previous experience or education. And in this video, I want to talk to you about how to focus and get things done based on my experience. So the first piece of advice I have, and a lot of these things are going to be, I think, a little different than what you've heard elsewhere. The first thing is, I've noticed that if you're having trouble focusing on something, it's probably not your fault. This is something, this is one of the things I have to say about like public school. You know, so many people have trouble focusing in school and they think it's their fault and it's not. It's because you're being forced to study a lot of bullshit that is boring and that is impractical and that is very tedious. So in life, as I became older, I realized I was like, sometimes I have a very easy time focusing, and sometimes I have a terribly difficult time focusing, and it's simply based on my interest in what I'm doing. And as humans, this is, you know, not only are we highly and easily distracted, but we also have complete lack of self-awareness about what we're actually interested in. And our culture has conditioned us to believe we have to focus on shit that we hate, which is what most jobs are for most people. That's why I'm so passionate about teaching people about digital marketing and encouraging people to get high income skills in other areas too, like coding, provided you find it at least somewhat interesting. I'm not saying you should, you know, you're going to have rainbows and sunshine every moment of every day, but there should be a fundamental interest in whatever it is you're supposed to be focusing on. And so rather than trying to give you a bunch of tips and techniques to force yourself to focus on shit you don't want to focus on, take a step back. Ask yourself, what am I focusing on? That's why digital marketing was so liberating for me and so many of my students. I was finally in a world and in a field where I was like, wow, I'm actually interested in this. And then your focus naturally goes through the roof. You know, I remember when I was, you know, when I was in school and at other jobs, I had a really terrible time. I wouldn't say I was able to focus just because it's kind of my, I was good at academics, but when I got to college, oh, I hated studying so much. I hated the textbooks were so dense, the topics sucked, and that's when I was really struggling because I just hated it so much. And I could force myself to do it, but I hated it. And when I got into digital marketing, I was just, there was no forcing. I was just like, oh my God, this is so cool. This is so interesting. I would spend 10, 12 hours a day learning about this stuff. Now a lot of my students, they have that same experience. So what are you focusing on? Obviously, there are going to be things in our lives that we have to take care of, errands. You know, you have to, maybe you have to do budgeting. You have to pay bills, of course. We'll talk about that in a minute. I don't have any tips for you on that. I'm talking about big picture stuff. That brings me to my second point, which is about priority management. People talk about time management, and I think time management is really useless for most people because it's usually, what are you going to become more skilled at getting menial stuff done? What I focused on is something called priority management because I'm not the best at time management. I like to waste time. I like to goof off. I like to do things at my own pace, but I'm very good at priority management. Priority simply means I'm very clear on what are my priorities. And that is something most people have not examined. What are your priorities? Unfortunately, as we're growing up, most of us are told that our priorities should be school, 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 and all these academic topics and learning a bunch of dates, historical dates, and biology and chemistry, which is absurd if you're not going to become a chemist or a physician, right? So you're already screwed up because you've never really learned how to prioritize properly. And that's why I teach people to focus on high income skills and making money, because once you have your finances taken care of, then you can focus on other things with much more ease, things like happiness and fulfillment and your family and creativity and things like that. But you really need to take a step back and ask yourself, what are your priorities? What are my priorities? Are they my priorities? Are they my family's priorities? And as you become more of an adult, you have the power and the right to say, this is what I want to prioritize, which is another reason why when people get my course, they become so successful because they make digital marketing and learning a new skill their number one priority. And that's really it when it comes to focus for me. When I've had to make a new course, it just becomes my priority. When I have something I need to get done for my business, it becomes my priority. And I don't worry about time management. It just naturally, inside of your mind, the thing that is your highest priority is going to take, it's going to naturally reorganize things inside your mind when you have your priorities set. The problem is if you have something else as your number one priority, then it's very hard to get to the thing you really want to do, and that's when people struggle with their focus. But like when I was like switching over a platform for my business, or I have to answer student emails, this is always a priority for me. So yeah, I might put it off for a little while. I might have a couple of unproductive days, but I always get to it, and when I do it, I'm completely focused. Because mentally, emotionally, it's my priority. So if you have things in your life that are, quote unquote, that are your priorities, but it's by default, or the things you really aren't lined up with, question that. That's the simplest advice I can give you. I don't want to give you a bunch of tactics and techniques to trick yourself and force yourself to like, oh, I need a way to be more productive at this thing I hate. No, examine what it is you're doing. Even for those people, I have students sometimes who are working a full-time day job. You've got to take care of a family. You can't just focus on the things that you enjoy, right? And I get that. You have to go to work. You have to do this. You have to earn the money. But one of the things I talk about Skip College for Success is this pyramid of attention. Because it's like, okay, if you have a higher priority outside of your fundamental, like, basic necessities, that is very inspiring. Like, when somebody's working full-time, but then they have digital marketing as their priority, even if they don't have as much time to put into it, it has a huge impact on their livelihood, their mood, productivity, everything, because now you have a goal that inspires you, that is your priority, even though you do have to take care of all this other stuff in your life. So that's really the secret of my focus. Like when I didn't think I was that great at focus until I found stuff that I wanted to focus on. And like when I made the digital marketing course, 3 months, I was just focused. I didn't do anything else. I barely focused on my food, friends, anything. I was completely focused. And you'll find that in life, guys, there's nobody that's born without the ability to focus. You know, kids have incredible focus, and you'll see this in all sorts of people. They say, well, they can't focus on this topic, but when it comes to, you know, you hear the same story again and again. It's like, well, Joe hates, you know, he hates school, he doesn't like this course, but when it comes time to playing music or drawing or whatever other topic, he's 100% focused, or Mary is 100% focused on this other topic. It means the person has the ability to focus, but they're not being allowed to focus on the thing that's right for them. So that's my main lesson for you guys. Like, pick something that you want to focus on. And if you are forced to focus on something because you have to get it done, obviously, you know, paying bills, you need to go to a day job, that's fine. Make something else your priority so that you have something to inspire you that in the back of your mind that keeps you, you know, in a higher vibration. You know, I said, if you're working a day job with no vision in your life, it's very tedious and it can be really life soul sucking. If you have a vision of something else you want to focus on, even while you're working that day job, you'll feel great. You'll feel much better. And that's it. And if you, guys, a lot of you are struggling because you've been told you're supposed to focus on this bullshit, whether it's school or you're supposed to be in some career. You know, I met so many people who are, you know, I need to be an engineer. I need to be a lawyer. Because your culture or your family told you that. And then people are miserable and they can't focus. Or if they do focus, it's at such a great expense. I have friends. You know, this is one of the saddest things I've seen in cultures. I had friends growing up who were incredible artists, so gifted. And some of them went off into other careers. And you can just see it on their face now that they are unhappy. Or they may be somewhat happy, but there's a certain kind of pain just in their face that you can tell because the person is not doing what fulfills them. So anyway, that's one of my main secrets for focus. And the other element of focus, other than, you know, priority management and focusing on something that you actually enjoy, is the third thing is get rid of your distractions, guys. Get off social media. It's another thing. Get newsfeed eradicator for Facebook. I've been using it for years. I never look at the newsfeed. I really look at LinkedIn. I only look at Instagram every once in a while, even though I use it for my business. I'm telling you, if you're creative, if you're focused on something, if you want to feel good, don't get sucked into social media. It's just people projecting all their shit out into the universe. Sometimes it's okay to check it out for a minute, see what people are up to. But I'm telling you, I have done this experiment. I have gotten off social media. I have stopped watching the news. I feel so much lighter, so much better when I am not allowing my attention to be influenced by all these random forces out there. Your attention is a valuable, precious instrument. Advertising companies, corporations pay billions of dollars every year to get a little bit of your attention. So don't give your attention away to social media or the news or all these external things when you have a goal in your life and you have something you want to focus on. Enjoy. The more you learn to enjoy the things you're focusing on, the more of a charge you'll get from just focusing on the creative, you know, learning and growing. Like, I remember I used to wake up in the morning, and I still do this. I wake up in the morning when I have a project I'm focusing on, and that becomes my priority. It becomes very exciting. I can't wait to get out of bed to work on it. Versus there have been times in my life where I wake up and the first thing I'm doing is checking the news or checking my social media. It's a very different feeling. It's ultimately a distraction. I don't post, comment, get involved. Guys, these conversations can become so distracting. I'm telling you, we do it all the time. Keep a journal, keep a record, be aware of how much time you're spending on social media. Unless you're using it for your business or it's very intentional, I would get off there. That's another great way to stay focused. And then the last thing, when you're actually sitting down to work, one of the things I did discover a tool I'm gonna recommend. It's called Focus at Will. And this is music. So when I'm working, I love to listen to music. I usually would just listen to whatever music I happen to be into. I love swing music, I love rock music, I love EDM. I like all kinds of music, and I would just throw on random music while I was working. And I noticed that I did notice at a certain point, certain music I seemed to perform or was able to focus better. So one day, Focus at Will, I found their website, and they were saying that they've done scientific studies about different rhythms and different frequencies, how it impacts the brain of different people in terms of focus. And I thought it sounded a little bit like pseudoscience or BS, but I tried it because I had a free trial. And I actually discovered that when I would listen to their mix based on a personality test I took, I was able to focus even more. And I still use this software. It's kind of nutty. I analyze the types of tracks that they play for me. It's usually a certain kind of instrumental with a certain kind of rhythm. And it does have this effect where when I'm working on, you know, a project, I'm grading student projects, I'm writing content, it's somehow I find myself spaced in, as you call it. I find myself just more easily able to, you know, focus my mind on whatever it is I'm doing, just a bit easier. And it has made a big difference because they actually have a time log, and I would notice, I'd say, I'd listen to the music, and I'd look up and like 30 minutes, an hour would go by. And this was distinct from when I was just grabbing free YouTube music on relaxation, which is great too. I mean, I'm not disparaging any of that. I just did notice a difference. So I put a link to that below this video if you want to check it out. But whatever tools you have to focus, again, I think they're not worth as much unless you have gotten your priorities right, guys. It's your life. It's your mind. It's your spirit. You have the freedom to choose what you want to focus on. And I'm telling you, even if you're somebody that thinks you have a short attention span, somebody who thinks you have trouble focusing, my opinion is it's because you've not been able to focus on things that really resonate with you. So, and that's something I use in my, you know, when I'm determining how I'm going to spend my time. Because if I feel I pushed myself to get things done that I wasn't able to focus on very easily, it's never really been the best thing for me. When I find something that I like focusing on, even related to my business, I find it to be yield the best results. Last note is meditation. Taking five minutes in the morning to do some kind of meditation, whatever form you like, even just sitting, watching your breathing, deliberately not engaging with your thoughts, but staying present with your breath, gives you a foundation of clarity where focus and thinking clearly is much more possible. Clear thinking, guys, especially today when we're just inundated with crap from the internet, from the media, from everyone around you. Clear thinking is your most valuable asset. So the more you clear your mind, the more you're able to think clearly, make good decisions, focus. That is my advice about how to focus and get things done. So anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed this. I kind of just freestyled this off the top of my head. I would say off the top of my heart because I do feel passionate about it. Please leave a comment below. Any questions, feel free to post them, and I will be back soon with more walkthrough videos and interviews and other inspiring stuff about digital marketing. Be well, and I will see you soon.